way back, if you dance and you complete school, they tell you, after SS, no, Asanasa, like, you can't take dance anywhere after school. But we are still here by the help of social media and the fans out there. My name is Incredible Ziggy, a professional dance artist and choreographer from Ghana. I've been able to travel around the world with dance. You know, I've been able to teach dance in the UK. I've been to Russia to teach dance. I've been to Rwanda to teach dance, Nigeria. You know, I'm doing it big in my own country here. You know, dance has really helped me a lot. I've been able to create more dance steps that has gone viral. You know, this coupé dance step that trended some time ago, I was the creator of the coupé dance step. Janet Jackson performed my Pilolo and coupé dance step on the Jimmy Fallon show. This recently ended Afro Nation that happened here in Ghana this December. I was a co-choreographer aside Ezio, DG, the main choreographer. So I knew I could dance from childhood. You know, when I was little, I used to be the life of the parties. Anytime there's a party, my parents would be looking for me. Where's Mickey? Where's Mickey? Come dance, come dance. Then I'll dance, they'll give me coke. Sometimes they give me the 500 coin, like old currency. You know, I used to be hailed at parties. When I'm not around, like the party is not lively. I used to be the life of most of the parties. Started dancing at weddings, you know, funerals. Even when I'm not invited, I'll just leave home. When I hear there's music somewhere, I'll just go dance. Even with chaps, chalote, I'll just walk, go dance and come back home. My parents will be looking for me. I'll tell them, oh, I went to dance here. Got to some point, they didn't even like the idea. I've not had any professional training. It's been my talent and the passion. And being consistent is also one thing because I kept doing it. Even when they told me to stop, I was still doing it. I went to school, JHS, I was still doing it. Primary, doing it. SHS, still doing it. University, I won so many awards just with dance. So I thought, yo, I can make something out of it. There's been so many challenges. You know, sometimes I wouldn't even be having money to go for a show. I have to walk. After the show, I'll wait for everybody to go, put earphones in my ear and walk to my destination. Sometimes I'll rehearse, go for a show, then they'll just push me aside. Charlie, we know they need dancers for here. We don't need dancers here, it's only artists. There's a whole lot, but then here we are now. So far, Ghana dance is doing so well. But if you travel around, people want to pay and come see Ghanaians dance. Azonto puts Ghana on the map. Everybody was doing Azonto for the past years, and the name is still prominent. Like, it's in the system now. If you talk about Azonto, everybody can do this and show you Azonto. When it comes to African countries, when it comes to dance, I say Ghana is number one. No doubt about it. You can argue with your ancestors. Ghana is number one. But then when it comes to global, like other countries, I'll put Ghana on number two. Don't question me, number two. Dance is the expression of your feeling through the movement of your body. So like, why wouldn't you want to take it as a career? Like something you love doing. I mean, gone are the days when you tell your mom, oh, I want to be a dancer. Your mom will look at you like, hey, see, all the money I'm paying for your school, you want to be a dancer. But now, you know, with the progress that's going on, with the help of social media, our works are being put out there. Myself and some few people are trying to make dance on the map right now. We are trying to put Ghana dance on the map right now. I think I'd advise someone to take dance as a career.